Good morning, everybody. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. We are in the Ayurvedic College, Nigdi Pradhikaran, Pune 44. In front of me are the PG students who are doing the post-graduation, that is MD in Ayurveda. And today, that is on 4th of August 2018, the day is a Saturday, and we will see Ayurvedic treatment for Grahani. Today's disease will be Grahani. This is the Sanskrit name, Grahani. Actually, it is very interesting to note that to give the names to the disease, there are the different methods in Ayurveda. Sometimes the name is based on the dosha, which dosha is mainly affected. For example, Vata Vyadhi. When we say Vata Vyadhi, it clearly idea that the disease are predominantly because of the Vata Dosha problem. Some disease names are based on dhatus. For example, Rakta Pitta. So Rakta is a dhatu and Pitta is a dosha. Sometimes the names are given according to the chief complaint. Atisara, Gudena Bahudravasarana Matisara. So loose motions, this is a symptom. And based on that, the name is given. And some names are given according to organ. For example, Grahani is a name of actually organ. Anatomical structure is there in our body, in the gastrointestinal tract. But the same name of the organ is given to the name of the disease. Another example is Udara. This is one of the diseases in Ayurveda. So Udara is actually whole abdomen. And Udar is also considered as ascites. So, disease name and the organ name is the same. And whenever there is a similarity in organ name and disease name, take into granted that that particular disease is very difficult to treat. Why I am mentioning that? Whenever the disease has a name of organ, that disease is definitely difficult to treat. Why? Because your organ has been damaged. So to recorrect that total organ, that means you know the concepts of stroto dushti, stroto vaigunya, etc. But here, the stroto vaigunya is total damage of that organ. So naturally, the functions are damaged and we can improve the stroto dushti, we can cut off the samprapti. But to recorrect that damaged system or damaged organ, it's very difficult. And that's why Grahani disease is also difficult to treat because it is the disease regarding the avayava or the organ Grahani. Again, what has to be considered as a Grahani? In GI tract, Ayurveda says there are three important viscera. One is amashaya, where the undigested matter is there, raw material is there, raw food is there. It is not actually processed by the gastric juice or intestinal juice or the pancreatic juice. It is just a collecting chamber, that is ama ashaya. Ama is a raw material. Then there is a grahani, where actually the digestion process is going on. So this is the chief organ where actually all the juices, they act strongly. In the stomach, pepsinogen, hydrochloric acid, they just begin the process. But actually final digestion of protein, carbohydrates and fats takes place in the small intestine, and that can be compared with the organ Grahani mentioned in Ayurveda. So Grahani can be compared with small intestine according to the modern anatomical structure. And then comes the organ Pakva Ashaya, where nearly all the digestion process has been completed, and so whatever the final product, pakva product, is coming into the pakvashaya and it is thrown out as a waste product. But before that, sara kitta vibhajan is taking place at the end part of Grahani. So beginning Grahani, first part, second part, third part. In the first and second part, there is a maximum digestion, which is the sthana of pachaka pitta according to Ayurveda. So this is the main factory, I can say, where your digestion takes place is a grahani, and at the, what you can say, the ileum part, where there are the villi, there actually final stage of sara and kitta takes place. Sara bhag, nutrient part, after the primary digestion or the sthula pachan, is absorbed, and the waste product is pushed into the pakva ashaya. I hope these basic anatomy and physiological ideas are very clear. And modern understanding is just for comparison. Ayurveda has its own fundamentals. So when I talk about grahani, there is a vata, pitta and kapha. Main vata dosha acting in this region, controlling the peristaltic movements. It is a samana vayu according to Ayurveda. Samana vayu, neuronal control. Then there is a pachaka pitta, which includes all the enzymes from the gastric juice, intestinal juice, pancreatic juice. All the enzymes, fiery substances, are included in the pachaka pitta. And all the mucoid secretions, whatever happening, mucoid glands are there, they are coming under the kledaka kapha. So in the grahani, for the pachana, there should be balanced state of pachaka pitta, samana vayu and kledaka kapha. This is Ayurvedic terminology. So what are the causes? Why this particular disease is created? This is not a one day or the one week job. This organ is damaged when there is a repeated attack of any pathology regarding this organ. As I am saying, this is the main site for Agni. So whatever the reasons that are damaging Agni will definitely be the problem for that organ. So causes of Agni Mandya are causes of grahani. Causes of ajirna are the causes of grahani. Causes of anna vah sroto dushti are the causes of grahani. So basic thing that the patient is neglecting his minor complaints here and there. He is not bothering. He is very neglecting the fundamentals of health, fundamentals of dietetic rules mentioned in Ayurveda, which is called as a ashtau, ahar, vidhi, visheshayatana. My dear listeners, don't get bothered about this big Sanskrit word. The simple translation is Ayurvedic eating rules. Ayurvedic eating rules. What is the simple rule? Everybody should eat at proper definite time. Lunch time should be around 12 o'clock. Dinner time should be around 7 to 8 o'clock. This is common sense. But many people don't follow it. Every time better to eat the warm and freshly cooked food. This is common sense, but the people are not following it. They take the food anytime. They take the food, non-homely food, hoteling food, outside food. And that can have a burden on your digestion system. Whenever your digestive system, you make it what you can say, the trouble, the God or the your nature can accept one time fault, two time fault, three time fault. But if you are doing the mistakes again and again and again and again, then this is the punishment of you will suffer from grahani. So grahani is a nature's punishment for your misbehavior for the diet and the lifestyle. If you are getting up very late in the morning, if you are going to bed very late in the evening, if you are drinking a lot of alcohol and making a destruction of your liver, which is a very supportive organ for the grahani, then naturally your grahani will be suffered, and that avayav, that organ, will give you the punishment. Okay, so you have understood what are the causes. What will be the effect? What will be the effect? Simple thing, the function of grahani, the main function of grahani, That is the sthula pachana, primary digestion, and after that sara kitta vibhajan, that will not be proper. Simple. What is the effect? Sara kitta vibhajan. For the non-Ayurvedic people, what is sara kitta vibhajan? Absorption of the food nutrients. Just to understand, for the non-Ayurvedic people, I will explain. Proteins are converted to amino acids. Carbohydrates are converted to glucose. Fats are converted to fatty acids. So, amino acids, glucose, fatty acids are sara part. This is sara. And formation of urine, stool and sweat, that is the kitta part. So there will not be proper amino acids, there will not be proper fatty acids, there will not be proper glucose. I think this parallel understanding of modern physiology is easier to understand Ayurveda also. Because otherwise there is a confusion. What is exactly sara? Now try to understand. What is the use of amino acids? This is the raw material for the further tissue metabolism. I am giving you parallel concepts. Remember, this sara bhag, according to Ayurveda, contains, what it contains? Nutrients to all tissues. And that nutrients reach to the respective srotas. That is, it will reach to the rasa dhatu, rakta dhatu, mausa, med, asthi, majja and shukra. According to you, understand, there is no difference in Ayurveda and modern physiology. There is no difference in Ayurveda and modern pathology. There is no difference of concept of treatment. Everything is parallel. There is no opposition of each other's concepts. But we have to understand what exactly both are meaning. When we say that ahara rasa will give the nutrition to the muscles, nutrition to the fats, that is nothing but the amino acids. Nothing but the your fatty substances. And that's why this grahani patient, the first complaint will be, as there is no nutrition to the sapta dhatus, grahani patient will suffer from weakness of one or many body tissues. I am not saying everybody will suffer from all the asara. I am not saying every tissue will be weak. In some people, there will be no prinana. Sreshta karma. Remember, the best functions of each dhatu is mentioned in Ayurveda. What is the shloka in Ayurveda? Prinanam jivanam lepaha. Sneho dharana purane. Garbhotpadascha dhatunam sreshtam karma kramat smrutam. This shloka is for Ayurvedic listeners. They will be happy. Now I want to happy to the other people also. They get afraid when they hear, what is that prinanam jivanam? Very simple. He will not get the proper energy, instant energy, enthusiasm. Grahani patient will be always tired, fatigued. No energy. Then he will have the low hemoglobin. He may have the anemia. Remember, grahani patient may have the anemia. So you must do the hemogram for the grahani patients. Then mouse lepana karma will not be there. He will lose the weight. There will be weight loss in the grahani patient. Remember my words. Weight loss. Because this grahani is not a 1 day, 2 days, 1 month, 2 month program. Grahani disease is chronic. The patient always have the complaints for years together. Indigestion for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, many years. And there is always on and off. Sometimes he is better, sometimes condition is very bad. But what is the final effect? His all the body tissues will be suffered, either off. Not all the time. Some will have weakness, some will have the anemia, some will have the weight loss. Then somebody lose the luster from the skin, they will be the dry skin. Medha dhatu is snigdha, lubrication. So there may be with a sound crepitus from the joints. He will complain, my joints are paining. My joints, while doing the movement, create some sound which is called as a crepitus. Standing, sitting, walking, there will be sound in the bones, in the joints. This is the complaints of, I am not talking about arthritis, I am talking about this grahani. So grahani can give the side effect as a complication as a arthritis. Ayurveda has also mentioned, ya eva purisha dhara kala, sa eva asthi dhara kala. So whenever your digestion suffers, you can get the problems of musculoskeletal disorders, arthritic problems. And it is not mentioned only in Ayurveda. Write down my words. You go and open the book of medicine. There is Crohn's disease, regional ileitis. Write down this word, please. Regional ileitis. Read in the Davidson. Read in the modern books of medicine. Crohn's disease, and you will find one symptom, that there is asymmetrical arthritis. So this Ayurvedic concept is also approved very well from the modern medicine. Now you will see, sir, Purisha Dhara Kala is different, na? Yes, different. But beginning is in the Grahani. Because Sara is damaged as well as Kitta is damaged. Even proper stool will not be there. The main problem of Grahani, tissues, dhatus will be weak, as well as mala will also suffer. No sara bhaga will be good, no kitta bhaga will be good. So he has the complaint always of loose emotions. Grahani patients will always suffer from intermittent diarrhea. Write down this word, intermittent diarrhea. So this is one of the, although there is one function that I am going to further, but before that, let me clear you, as I am telling you, this is a very important disease, chronic disease, very serious disease. Ashtangarudaya Vagbhat has mentioned Grahani in Ashtau Mahagad. This is theoretical information. Ashtau Mahagad, these are the very dangerous disease. Eight important diseases which can disturb the quality of life. What is the meaning of Ashtau Mahagad? Allopathy doctors will ask you. Foreigners will ask you, what is Ashtau Mahagada? Why only eight? So tell them that these eight diseases can damage the quality of the patient's life. And that's why, and also difficult to treat. Another important, Mahagada. Maha means great and Gada means disease. Why great disease? One is difficult to cure and second is disrupting, destroying the quality of life. Next point, as we are talking about Grahani, Samana Vayu, Pachaka Pitta. What is the function of Pachaka Pitta? The main Pitta, digestive fire, enzyme. Agnireva Shirire Pittantargataha. Ayurveda says there is a two different terms. Agni is a energy. Pitta is a matter. Ayurveda believes the Agni matter principle of physics. Energy is working always through the medium of matter. Try to understand. Very interesting. Here in the hall, auditorium, electricity is there. We cannot see the electricity. No, no. Indriya gamya. No. It cannot be perceived by senses. But I can see the tube light is on. Light is there. So tube light, fan, air conditioning, these are the matters. This is matter, and electricity is working, showing its function through the tube light, through the fan. Similarly, Agni is an energy working through Pitta dosha. Is it clear? And what is the function of Pitta? Pachaka Pitta, Annam Grunhati, or Samanvayu, Pachati, and Vivechayati. Samano Agni Samipastaha. Am I right? Annam Grunnati, intake, pachati, assimilation. Vivecheti, Sarakit, separation of the nutrients and waste product, and Munchati, to throw away the waste product. Four words are important. Grunnati, to take. Vivecheti, separation of Sar and Kitta, nutrient and waste product. Annam Grunnati, Pachati is first assimilation, digestion, then Vivechayan, and then Munchana, to throw away the stool part, solid part, to the large intestine. So don't forget this line. Annam Grunnati, Pachati, Vivecheti, Munchati. All these functions will be destroyed in the Grahani Vyadhi. Okay. So first there will be indigestion. Simple thing. Intermittent indigestion is a complaint of Grahani patient. Intermittent abdominal pain. Intermittent gas. Intermittent heaviness in the abdomen. So all these abdominal complaints will be there with the patient. Regarding the pachana, is it clear? He will be always complaining of, I am having loss of appetite, I don't have the appetite. There is heaviness in my stomach, there is a pain in my abdomen, there is a gas in my abdomen, local complaints. This is regarding the pachati, am I right? Then vivecheti, sara bhag will not be proper, kitta bhag will not be proper. Vivechan is wrong, pathology. Faulty, faulty sar, faulty kit. Okay? And munchati, expulsion or the defecation, stool excretion will not be proper. So there will be muhur baddham, muhur dravam. This is the pratyatma lakshana of Grahani Vyadhi mentioned by the text, Samhita, our rishis, acharyas. Muhur baddham, muhur dravam. I repeat the previous diseases that I discussed 2 days back. Atisar, what is the important feature of Atisar? Gudena bahudravasaranam atisaraha. Excessive loose motion is a feature of Atisar. Pravaha manasya pravahika. Straining is a feature of pravahika. Muhurbaddham muhurdravam, feature of Grahani. Little difference is there. Then, here there is one clarification. Some take it as a alternate diarrhea and alternate constipation. But some believe every time it is not necessary that he has a constipation. Sometimes there is a binding stools. That means there will be solidity form of the stool and many times it will be liquid. So don't take it as a, but the means doesn't mean all the time hard stools. So it can also be converted into the language. In Grahani Vyadhi, there will be up and downs in the symptoms. Up and down. So another way, although it is not mentioned in the text, it can be considered as a Vega Avastha and Avega Avastha. So when there is a liquid stool, it is an exacerbation of the problem. And sometime it will be better. Sometime it will be better. So it may be Baddha. But remember, these are the periods of the different type of the, what you can say, the exploitation of the symptoms. It is not on the one day. That means it is not like that. Tomorrow, liquid. Afternoon, solid. Again, evening, liquid. This is not like that. 8 days, 10 days, there will be fluid stools. Then some days will go little bit solid stool. So in this way, this cycle goes on in the chronic phase for years together. Or months together. So, there will be loose motion, there will be some solid stools. Interesting finding is that sometimes it is observed that he has not to go to the toilet for many times, but the quantity of stools is more sometimes. This is very similar to the malabsorption syndrome. Grahani, we can take the modern malabsorption syndrome also here. Like a conditions of stitoria, when the patient is consuming more fatty substances, he is not able to digest. Grahani patient will not be able to digest. And what will happen? Much more frothy stool will come. Quantity will be large, but that is not actually the normal stool. That is, undigested part is there, but the quantity is large. And frothy is there, stickiness is there. And that is called as a stitoria in modern medicine. That can be included under the large umbrella of Grahani. So Grahani can include many diseases from the modern medicine regarding the intestines. Remember these things. And we have to check out exactly by which problem this Grahani is going on. Sometimes it is also possible that this patient is suffering from abdominal tuberculosis. Mind my words. So we just do not neglect those parts. So you have to rule out by sonography, by stool examination, culture and sensitivity. Everything possible investigation can be done, and we have to be sure that there is no another very serious pathology. Even if you find there is sometimes blood is coming, then don't hesitate to do the scopy. You can advise for sigmoidoscopy. It may be the ulcerative colitis. It may be the colon cancer. So all these possibilities should be ruled out, because this is a differential diagnosis with concern to the Grahani. Remember, because there is some misunderstanding that Ayurvedic people should not do the investigation. This is not at all correct. So in the Grahani especially, why? Because this is chronic. And we just go on treating by our medicines and we don't do the investigation. Sometimes Ayurvedic Vaidya can land into the trouble. After last stage of any disease, the patient will be admitted in the modern hospital, and there they will find biopsy that his patient is of colonic cancer. And Ayurvedic diagnosis was Grahani. He is the patient of HIV and the diagnosis was Grahani. I am not saying Grahani is the wrong diagnosis, but at the same time you must have the Vyavachedaka Nidana or differential diagnosis which can make your stools watery and which can have the chronic type of the pathology. So whenever there is a chronic pathology, chronic diarrhea or alternate diarrhea and constipation, especially in the old people, you must be very cautious. Alternate constipation and diarrhea is a typical feature of cancer. Or blood stool, always go for scopy, confirm it, there is no other pathology, and start, continue your treatment of Grahani. So this is my personal advice. Then, as I have told you, what are the symptoms we have already discussed? There will be anorexia, nausea, vomiting. These are all the features of Agnimandya. Aruchi, Chardi, Rullas. These are the Ayurvedic words. Aruchi means anorexia, Chardi means vomiting, Rullas means nausea. Regarding the whole body, I have discussed Saptadhatu. Kshaya will be there. Then weakness, Daurbalya, Krushata, weight loss. Local symptoms I have already mentioned. Shula, Udara Shula, that is pain in the abdomen, in the especially hypochondriac region, epigastric region. Tenderness, in Ayurveda it is called as Sparsha Sarathva. Tenderness can be there. And in the long run, very long, if the patient is of Grahani of 2 years you are treating, he may in one day suffer from serious complications. Number one, Pandu, anemia. So always look, check. Every 2 months you must do the hemogram. Number two, Arsha. Because it is affecting your waste product. So Arsha can be happen because of the straining, because of repeated irritation at the mucosal layer of the anus. So Arsha can happen. Then if liver is damaged, simultaneously, Udar can take place. So Udar may be the complication long run for the Grahani. And Shoth, that is edema, can be the complication of Grahani. Then Madhav Nidan, this is one of the texts, he has mentioned the word Sangrahani. But Sangrahani word is not in the Charak, Sushruta and Vagbhat, it is only in the Madhav Nidan. So it can be considered as a Tri Doshaja Grahani in the chronic stage, that can be called as a Sangrahani. Then, next, regarding the Samavastha and Niramavastha, this is a very important concept of Ayurveda. When the patient is suffering from liquid stools, Look for the foul smell and the stickiness. Whenever your stools are having tremendous foul smell or very stickiness to your toilet, it is very difficult to wash your anorectal region. Stickiness is there. Then Bhushadunagrandhi, this is the Ayurvedic word, and Styanatva, this is the another word. So these two things will tell you about the Samavastha. So in Samavastha, it is better to give the mild laxatives. Mild laxatives like Haritaki, Amalaki, Bahava. Haritaki, Abhayarisht, Amalaki Churna, Amalaki tablet, Bahava, Aragvada, Aragvadarishta is available, or Gandharva Haritaki Churna. Gandharva means Erenda, Ricinus communis, and Haritaki is Hirada. So first, Samavastha, Mrudu Anulomak, mild laxative. And then, you can give, after the Samavastha, you can give the Rasayana treatment for Grahani. Rasayana treatment for Grahani. But in Grahani, as far as possible, don't give the Stambhaka Aushadha according to Ayurveda. Don't try for Lomotil. Don't try for Lomofen. Don't try to control abruptly, because that waste product will remain in the body and that is not very good for the patient. So Grahi, Deepana and Pachana medicine should be given. Grahi, Deepana and Pachana. Grahi is a absorbent. Deepana, it is appetizer, Agni Deepana, and Pachana is a carminative, relieving the gas. Grahi, Deepan, Pachan, these are the Ayurvedic pharmacological words. Which are those medicines? Number one, Shunti. Shunt, dry ginger. You know, Trikatu is the best Deepana Pachan. Trikatu, katu means spices. Three herbal spices. Shunt, mire, pimpari. Shunt, ginger, piper, longam, pippali, and black pepper, that is marich, mire. Next is the nagarmotha. Musta or the nagarmotha is the best number one amapachak in Ayurveda. Musta, nagarmotha, number one amapachak. Shankha basma, kapardika basma, different types of parpati kalpa. This is very interesting. Parpati Grahani is equal to Parpati. Always, 10 times you mention in your mind. Grahani, treat with Parpati. Grahani, Parpati. Grahani, Parpati. Grahani is a so concrete relation. Grahani is always treated with Parpati. Takra, buttermilk, is the best. Whenever intestinal problem is there, their intestinal flora is damaged. And that lactobacillus is coming through the takra or the buttermilk. Here in the Grahani, Kapardik Basma is better useful than Shankha Basma. Shankha Basma is for the upper part of the GI tract and Kapardik Basma is on the lower Amashaya, Adho Amashaya, lower part of the GI tract. One of the important kalpa from Kapardik Basma is Loknath Rasa. Loknath Rasa is a medicine prepared from the Kapardik Basma. All the Parpati Kalpas are Grahi, Deepana, Pachan and Rasayana for the Grahani. You know the little bit interesting similarity? How the Parpati Kalpa is prepared? Do you have any idea? It's prepared, for example, we take the simple Parpati, that is Rasa Parpati, basic Parpati. It is prepared from mercury and sulfur, which is a catalyst, antiseptic, Yogavahi, MRI, Krumigna, Kajjali, prepared from the mercury and sulfur, it is heated, it is melted, and that is poured through iron vessel onto the banana leaf. Banana leaf is covered with the ghee. That Parpati liquid material will fall on that banana tree. Immediately, you have to spread another banana tea over it. Another banana leaf. So, in between, two banana leaves you are pressing the kajali, and after drying it becomes little bit solid. So that solid is like a very thin plate, and that is why it is called the parpati, and it is always in between two banana leaves. So what I mean to say, grahani or grahan is similar to the parpati because it is in between amashaya and pakvashaya. Grahani organ is in between amashaya and pakvashaya. Similarly, parpati is in between two banana leaves. And that is why, of course, this is something may not be very scientific, but is very interesting to similarity, understanding the similarity. So, names of the parpati kalpas. Different parpati kalpas are available as per the patient, as per the avastha or the stage of the disease. You can different parpati kalpas in grahani patient. Rasa parpati, panchamrut parpati, loha parpati, tamra parpati, suvarna parpati. So, in acute condition, when you feel that the patient is having since last 8 days this type of the loose motions and is also having the fever, then better start with the rasa parpati. This is simplest and antiseptic, antipyretic, anti-infective. So rasa parpati will be better in the acute stage to control loose motions with fever in the grahani patient. But if the patient is having weight loss in last 1 year, in last 6 months because of the grahani, he may have severe weakness, then you better use panchamrut parpati or suvarna parpati in chronic cases. Panchamrut parpati and suvarna parpati to develop the immunity of grahani. To develop the immunity of grahani. Even in the modern medicine, they are mentioning this sprue, non-tropical sprue or tropical sprue. These are autoimmune diseases. The modern medicine also don't find any reason. But Ayurveda has found it reason. What reason they have found? It is because of your fault, Agnimandya. It is because of the patient's faulty lifestyle, faulty diet, eating habits. Ayurveda has found out the reason. But modern, because they don't go into the detail of the lifestyle and the diet. So they just mention this is autoimmune disease. Of course, we agree that we have the weak grahani and we have to improve the or make it a strong grahani by giving the rasayana treatment to the grahani organ. And how you give the rasayana? Panchamrut parpati and suvarna parpati. If grahani and having hemoglobin is low, anemic patient, loha parpati. Simple thing, loha parpati. Then there is also to control the acute conditions, especially when there is a loose motions with blood, kutaja parpati and bola parpati. These two names are important, kutaja parpati and bola parpati. Better way, all these parpati kalpas should be given with little bit ghee as anupana. Ghee, because Ayurveda believes that ghee is the best friend of Agni. Do you understand? Best friend of Agni. That means it will stimulate the Agni, but it will not make any harm. It will not be strong. Homeostasis of Agni will be maintained by ghee. And that is why grahani patient's medicine should have the anupana carrier. That is ghruta. Ghruta means ghee. Okay? Now I am giving you the ready-made prescription of the grahani. Ready-made prescription for grahani disease. Parpati, any parpati as you wish. Rasa, bola, kutaja, whatever. Either of, not all the parpatis one time. But according to the stage of the disease, you have to select the proper parpati. 250 milligram. Parpati kalpa, 250 milligram plus. Loknath rasa, 250 milligram plus. Nagakeshara, 250 milligram plus. Shunti, 250 milligram. Again, I repeat, all the four ingredients in one packet. In Ayurveda, in Marathi, we say, eka pudi madhe kaya asla paije. What one packet of dispensing should contain? Four elements. In acute condition, any parpati, lokanath ras, nagakeshar and shunti, each 250 milligram. In portal and mehesal, you have to make a trituration, khalvi. Then you have to give the powder, in the powder form, with little bit ghee, three times in a day. And intermittently during the lunch, basically, he should drink at least one small glass of buttermilk. There should be always buttermilk. Because buttermilk is deepana, pachana, grahi and laghu. Very interestingly, how it acts on the three doshas. Takra is a madhur vipaki. Remember, takra is a madhur vipaki. So there is no problem for pitta. There is no problem of pitta. Then, anurasa is a kashaya. Anurasa is a kashaya. And also little bit ushna. So it is kafagna also. Not severely hot, but it's little bit ushna. Just to stimulate the fire. So it is kafagna. And as it is having basic taste as a madhura and amla together, that is also vatagna. So buttermilk is a three doshagna, and many times it is said, takram shakrasya durlabham. This is a Sanskrit proverb or subhashit. Takram shakrasya durlabham. What does it mean? Takra is also rarely available for even the god of king of gods, that is Indra. Indra has amruta, but he don't have the buttermilk. So buttermilk is like amruta for the people living on this earth. This sentence is very important. But of course, that buttermilk should always be fresh, and it should be prepared with the admoro dahi in Marathi. It is not very, very sour. Curd should not be there. It is little bit in between, madhura, sweet and little bit sour. Okay. Then, when the grahani is a sannipatik and very chronic, then again, three doshaja grahani, you have to use the suvarna parpati and panchamrut parpati. And then there, you can use, in spite of only lokanath ras, sometimes suvarna lokanath ras can be tried. Suvarna lokanath ras. Gold is always giving you the strength to your whole body. Remember, sapta dhatu poshan karnara. This is the gold. Gold is a sapta dhatu poshak, nutrient for all the tissues. Then on and off, acts per the stage, there are some different medicines you can use. Kutajarishta, Kutajavaleha, Sanjivani Guti, Bhallataka Parpati. These medicines can also be used in the chronic grahani or sangrahani. And if at all, if there are complications like udara, ascites, shoth, edema, or arsha, that is piles, then of course you have to treat those particular diseases as per their own management. That means their management will be little bit again complicated and different also. This is the grahani. Our discussion was mainly on the plain grahani without any much complications. So complicated cases will be differently treated as per the Vaidya's decision. Regarding the parpati only, I want to tell you, when it has to be used as a rasayana, it can be used in a increasing dose. For example, only one tablet for 3 days, then one BD for 3 days, one TDS for 3 days. In this way, gradually you can increase up to the 15 days, and then gradually again you can reduce the dose of parpati. So Vardhamana Matra. This Vardhaman concept is basically given in the text as a Vardhamana Pippali Rasayan mentioned by Charak in the Shwas Vyadhi or in the respiratory problems. But the same thing regarding the parpati kalpa, many Vaidyas follow the Vardhamana style of the management, not giving only same dose for all the days. Is it clear? So this is something that we have discussed today about the grahani. I hope Ayurvedic treatment of Grahani is little bit very clear. So this is the end of today's lecture, that is on Saturday, 4th of August 2018. Professor Dr. Deshpande has discussed the Grahani disease with the PG students. But this is not only for the CARC. I request my students as well as the listeners to share this video as much as possible and also subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much and have a nice day ahead. Thank you.